Hello, Knights. Welcome back to the studio.
In this week's episode, we got more information on First Friday, learned more about Mrs. Hemmerly, and quizzed our student body on just how much they know about Martin Luther King Jr.
Now let's get this show started. Good time we had.
Here comes an all-new episode of The Studio.
Reporting to you now, I'm Lily Varso.
And I'm Taylor Knutschel.
So Taylor, have you ever heard of First Friday?
I don't think so. It sounds like it's the first Friday and that already passed.
Well, First Friday is a community event located in downtown Phoenix where people can look at several forms of art, each created by artists on the first Friday of each month. Nick, Ethan, and Mitch have more information. Girl, I got you on my mind.
The city of Phoenix is a very active city in terms of events going on in the community. One of these events is First Friday, a local event that promotes art.
I went to First Friday so I can experience the live music, the art, and the delicious food. It's pretty great.
Doing a self-guided art walk on the street is interesting, but you won't have experienced First Friday without visiting the Phoenix Art Museum.
It's actually one of the biggest art museums on the Southwest region.
In the early 1900s, you know, Philip C. Curtis, we have a bunch of his stuff, and Lou Davis, and the Southwest art scene was just very prominent, and it was a great starting place for a lot of women artists that were just breaking out of traditional gender roles and wanting a place where they can be free. And we have a lot of it on display, and the Phoenix Art Museum started out of that movement.
The Phoenix Art Museum has many cool exhibits that each deliver a unique experience.
My favorite part about the Phoenix Art Museum is actually the Yayoi Kusama exhibit. That's the firefly exhibit that you guys got to check out earlier with all the lights. I think that's something that everybody can enjoy.
Right now, my favorite part of the Phoenix Art Museum is Ragnar Kjartansson. The Visitors, it's a big musical piece. They have 9 different tracks and you feel like you're in this old house in upstate New York. It's like an hour long song and it's just like perfect harmony and just beautiful music.
Check out First Friday, any first Friday of the month. Also be sure to come see the Teotihuacan exhibit in the Phoenix Art Museum before it closes on January 27th. This is Nick, Mitch, and Ethan reporting for the studio.
Come join Science Club to share your love of science with other like-minded people. If you're interested in checking it out, they meet in Miss Gal's room every Thursday after school.
Best Buddies had a party last week where our fellow classmates got to spend time with one another. If you are interested in joining this club, be sure to talk to Miss Wittenberg today.
The Gilbert Police Department is now accepting applications for their Youth Leadership Academy that will be held this summer. See Mrs. Skoda or Officer Arrowsmith for more information.
Our school's musical program has many talented and gifted students. Nadia tells us more about All Region and just how hard everyone needs to practice to make it into the bigger programs.
Tomorrow is All Region auditions, and this is an important day for students in Higley's Performing Arts program. Students from our orchestra, band, and choir classes will be heading out to try out to be a part of a large ensemble compiled of many students from other schools. I had the opportunity to learn more about how 3 students came to hear about this event.
I heard about it from one of my senior friends around 2 years ago, so I thought that would be something cool to do.
I heard about regionals from Mr. DeCoste. I've done regional auditions since 7th grade.
I first heard about regionals my freshman year when Jacob Anderson made it all the way up to Allstate. He told me about how it was a lot of fun to do and how he got to work with a lot of professionals.
With each student trying out with different instruments, the way they practice for the audition is all but the same.
Well, I have to audition for like a couple different instruments and everything. So I have to do like some mallet things, some drumming, and like some timpani things and stuff like that.
The audition process involves one piece that you sing through, memorize. You also have a sight reading section and then 2 pages of music.
We have to play scales, arpeggios. We have to play three excerpts from the given pieces, and then we have a set of sight reading.
The students' drive towards success is all thanks to the learning they got from their teachers. They are proud of every student who will be going out to perform for All Region.
When a student goes out for All Region, the first thing they have to do is take a lot of responsibility on themselves, and they have to do a lot of preparation.
By making one of the All Region groups, they get to perform in a different type of ensemble that has complete instrumentation, and then they're a large ensemble, so they learn better how to be able to blend and work with a large group of people.
To be honest, I think it's going to be a pretty good result. The kids who generally do this are some of our stronger performers in the program, the ones who are always auditioning for solos in class.
Make sure to wish every student who will be trying out the best of luck, as they will be representing our school with pride. Coming from the studio, I'm Nadia Garsho.
On Wednesday night, 8th graders and their parents came to check out all that Higley has to offer, from elective courses and clubs to AP offerings. These future Knights are now better prepared for their registration process. We can't wait to have them here next year.
Miss Emily has been a teacher at Higley for 5 years now.
She's an amazing leader to both her staff members and students every day, and always makes sure to keep a positive mindset no matter what.
So for those of you that sit there and have no idea who we're talking about, Carson and I went over and interviewed her about her life both inside and outside the classroom.
Let's take a look at this week's teacher feature.
So if you have 10, 36, and 37,
Mrs. Hermely is a teacher here at Higley and has made an impression on her students and staff from now and previous years. Karsten and I went over to talk to her more about how she got into teaching.
My name is Mrs. Hermely and I've been teaching here for 5 years, and I teach honors geometry and geometry, so I have freshmen and sophomores. I felt really drawn to math. My 7th and 8th grade teacher, she was my pre-algebra teacher. She was my favorite teacher, Miss Abul, and I felt really strongly that, like, if I was going to be a teacher, I wanted to be just like her. I love teaching here. I have great coworkers, and they're honestly the best. They're so good at what they do, and I want to, you know, continue to always be improving, and so there are people that I feel like I can do that with. And then I just love the students here. I've had just great classroom experiences. There's a lot of students here that really do work hard and try hard, and that's all I could ever ask for. So that's what I love.
One activity she enjoys doing in her free time is going on hikes with her family. We wanted to know why she enjoyed this hobby and how often she does it.
One of the things we do like to do is go hiking, because that's something that my kids can do with us. It's just an enjoyable thing we can do as a family, which I love, and we live on the mountain, so we can just go right from our backyard. My littlest one is almost 18 months, so he's not a very confident walker yet, so we still kind of like strap him in the little backpack seat, and then my older one is 4, and he loves to hike, so that's really fun. He likes to collect a lot of things and hide them in his pockets. Usually we hike to the top of the mountain, and then we say, okay, where's Grandma's house? And he tries to like point it out, or where's school?
Be sure to say hello to Mrs. Hummerly the next time you see her. This is Taylor and Karsten reporting from the studio. Winter Formal is this Saturday. If you haven't bought your ticket already, be sure to get one at either A or B lunch today for $20. They will also be sold at the door of the dance for $25. Hope to see you there.
For this year's dance, the administration has asked that students enter from the student parking lot through the North 700 building entrance, past the locker rooms, and into the cafeteria.
Congratulations, Corbin Pierce, on being selected to the 2019 AFJ ROTC Flight Academy, an 8-week Air Force-funded scholarship to attend private pilot training at a public/private universities during the summer of 2019. The scholarship is awarded to highly competitive cadets who are interested in aviation careers. Corbin is one of the 5 AFJ ROTC cadets in Arizona to receive this scholarship, and one of only 250 in the United States.
ACT prep is now starting for the students here at Higley. Every student has to go through this prep, whether they like it or not. So to give some more information on what there is to look for when getting ready, Lily has the story.
It's that time of the year, Knights! With the ACT just around the corner, I talked to a few students about their ACT experiences and how their studying is going so far.
The ACT exam is a test made by the College Board in order to test students on their intelligence as well as open opportunities for potential scholarships and get acceptance into colleges.
So the colleges can look at this and be like, we want you, we choose you. It's also good for scholarships. So if you can't pay for college, like most of us can't, and we don't want to go into serious debt, please get a good grade on this.
Even though this test isn't for a grade, it is not something to walk blindly into.
I absolutely would recommend it to every single junior to study. Let me tell you, it helps so, so much. I didn't exactly study for the ACT during my junior year. However, after taking it again my senior year, and I did actually study this time, I did raise my score by 2 points, and it really helped me out a lot.
I'm kind of nervous to take the test, but at the same time kind of not, because we can take the test over again. I just also don't want to have to pay money for that. So I want to get it done now, and that makes me kind of anxious to get it right first time.
If you're not sure what to do to study for the test, here's some tips from your fellow students.
So in order to study for the ACT, I did look up online tests and use the actual ACT website.
I got a study guide from the counseling office. It's free, which is very good. And it goes through all these sorts of different questions, and it's really helped me look over things.
Be sure to study, Knights. This has been Lily Barstow reporting for The Studio.
Our nation's schools are full of students who possess the desire to go to college and willingness to work hard, but many of them are not truly prepared for the college and career path ahead of them.
The ADVID program on our campus is designed to help students succeed on the road to college and career success. We sat down with Mrs. Moda to find out what attending college did for her.
So college did a lot for me. So my favorite thing that it allowed me to do is open my eyes to the world. My senior year of college, I had the opportunity of studying abroad in Argentina. It allowed me to experience the world in a whole different way that I had never seen it before. I had never traveled abroad before. I got to meet new people and see things that I never thought would be imaginable. And it made me fall in love even more with Spanish, which ultimately made me become a Spanish teacher.
Girls soccer has a game this Friday at Campo Verde High School, as well as boys soccer. Be sure to come support.
Fusion Cheer Gym is a place where students can go to not only take cheer, but also gymnastics and even ninja classes. Campbell and Ashton went over there to learn more.
Arizona Fusion Cheer and Tumble isn't your average cheer gym. It's also a place for gymnastics cheerleaders full of people with passion. But even more than that, it's a place to make lasting friendships.
I picked cheer because I'd been doing gymnastics a really long time before we moved out here, and I decided to start going to a cheer gym instead, and it just stuck with me. The best thing about Fusion is how much of a family it is. There's not a lot of girls there, so we're all really tight-knit.
The biggest thing at Fusion we pride ourselves on is being a family. We want you to walk in the door and feel welcomed. We want to know everyone's first name, your child's name, even if your child's not in our program. We want it to be very family-friendly orientated, down to our snack bar, to our classes, what we wear. That's really what we want people to take away, that they feel comfortable and that they grew in an environment that was safe. I think that the coaching techniques that are different for us is some of us on staff are now moms, so I think we're able to relate to kids better when they have bad days, when they're just feeling sad. We're able to relate to them on more of a personal level, not just on a cheer level. That's what makes us different. We're not just coaching cheer, we're coaching human beings.
Since I've become a coach, I've really noticed how much the coach puts in for the athlete and how much they care about them. Like, since I've started working there, I start feeling that for my kids in my class, so it's a big change.
There are various levels at which cheerleaders can compete, from beginner to experience.
So we offer 4 different levels of cheerleading. Everyone starts in what we call rec cheer, which is an introduction. It's only 8 weeks long. Then most people go into what we call Showstoppers, which is a performing program. They do local events. Then from there, you have two different categories of competitive. We have traveling teams versus non-traveling, where some just compete in-state, others compete out-of-state in Vegas and Anaheim.
I am on the All-Star program at Fusion, so I go 3 times a week for practices, and we run our routines and we learn them. We stunt getting ready for competitions. Black Tsunami is a senior 4 level. It's the highest level at Arizona Fusion. Senior means is the age level, and then level 4 is the highest level you can go before you hit world's levels. So we do the highest level of tumbling and stunting, and it's really engaging and hardworking.
You can find the Fusion Gym at this address. This is Ashton and Campbell signing out.
Freshmen and sophomores, if you would love to produce your own videos for YouTube or just make fun videos with your friends, Video Production 1 might be the perfect elective for you next year. Learn to shoot, edit, and produce videos using professional equipment and software. Video Production 1 is the first step on the road to becoming a crew member on this show, The Studio. Sign up today.
A student named Trey Wiggins recently started going to Higley this year. His story has yet to be told, so Lily caught up with him to tell us more about how he got to Higley.
Higley recently gained a new student. Travion Wiggins has a unique story on how he ended up here at Higley.
I got in trouble with the law in January, and they sent me to Kenya State to live for a little bit. So I was there for 11 months, and while I was there, I chose to have a mentor.
How Trey came into our lives is interesting because I started mentoring through a program called Arizonans for Children to mentor foster children, and they said that males and teenagers get looked over quite a bit from people who want to mentor, so I decided I wanted to choose a teenager.
I had her for like 2 months, and she decided to take me because no one else would take me.
Something we wanted to do was to adopt him, and we went through a process, and on November 2nd, we went to court, and he actually came to live with us, and we got custody of him on November 2nd, and we couldn't be happier with the decision we made.
Trey has really been enjoying the change of going from a juvenile detention school to attending a public school like Higley.
She took me in about a month ago, and she asked me what school I wanted to go to. I said I wanted to go to Higley.
We enrolled him in Higley because of the academic and the athletic programs that they have to offer, because he's very athletic and wants to play football, and we felt like that was a good match for him, and we're excited to see what he does next year.
I've heard a thing about Higley so far, the sports program and the people. They're cool here. They all get along. Higley is different from my old school because, you know, there's not that much violence going on all the time.
I think we all can agree that this is a change for the better. This has been Lily Barstow reporting for The Studio.
All right, Lily, do you know the day that Martin Luther King Jr. gave his I Have a Dream speech?
That was on August 28th, 1963, right?
Yeah, you're right, good job. As a commemoration for Martin Luther King Jr. Day, this past Monday, Grace and Vanessa went out and quizzed our Knights on just how much they really know about this day in history. Let's take a look.
This past Monday, students around the world didn't have school for a national holiday. Martin Luther King Jr. had a huge impact on the world and deserved recognition. So, first celebrated in 1986, Martin Luther King Jr. Day became a national holiday. Grace and I went around the school to quiz our fellow Knights on how much they know about MLK.
So the first question is, what year was Martin Luther King Jr. Day first celebrated?
1980s?
Probably the 80s.
Wait, what day?
What year?
Oh, what year? 1932.
1998.
1992.
1986.
Oh, it's close.
What year was Martin Luther King assassinated?
Oh God, the 1960s.
50s.
I don't even know what century it's in.
1968. The third question is, MLK Jr. was born in what state?
Georgia.
That's correct.
I don't know. Starts with a G.
Georgia!
There you go, it's Georgia.
Alabama?
Is it Missouri?
Georgia.
Oh.
All right. What was the last state to declare MLK Jr. Day a holiday?
Alaska.
It was Utah.
Utah.
That's correct.
Alabama? New York?
Utah.
I was gonna say that too!
There you have it, Knights. MLK goes deep into our history and is important for our society. It wasn't just an ordinary day off, it was MLK Day. This is Vanessa and Grace reporting for The Studio.
Thanks for tuning in this week, Knights.
We will be back next week with an all-new episode. See you then!
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at The Studio HHS.